Good morning students, welcome back to our biology class. Today we are going to learn about a carpel or pistil. What is carpel? It is the female part of the flower. Otherwise we can call it as a gynoecium. This gynoecium consists of three parts. They are stigma, style, ovary. These are the three parts of the carpel or gynoecium or pistil. First we can learn about stigma. What is a stigma? Stigma is the terminal noble-like part. It may be divided into two or more lobes and may assume a feathery appearance. It serves as the landing place for pollen during pollination. What is stigma? It is the terminal noble-like part of the carpel. It may be divided into two or more lobes and may assume a feathery appearance. It serves as the landing place for pollen during pollination. That is the role of stigma. Next part is style. It is the slender tube-like structure which connect stigma to the ovary. What is style? It is the slender tube-like structure which connect stigma to the ovary. That part we can call as style. Okay, next last part is ovary. Ovary is the swollen basal portion of the carpel where ovules are present. What is ovary? It is the basal portion of the carpel and it is swollen in nature, and inside this ovary ovules are present. Is it clear? Next we can learn types of carpels. There are four types of carpel in a flower. They are monocarpellary, multicarpellary, syncarpus and apocarpus. These are the four types of carpels present in a flower. First we can discuss about monocarpellary. What is the meaning of monocarpellary? If the gynoecium consists of a single carpel, that carpel we can call as monocarpellary. If the gynoecium consists of a single carpel, such a carpels we are calling as the monocarpellary. Then second type is multicarpellary. Multicarpellary means gynoecium consists of many carpels. That is known as multicarpellary. Next, syncarpus. If the carpels are united in nature, such a carpel we can call as syncarpus. If the carpels are united in nature, such a united carpels we can call as syncarpus. And last one is apocarpus. Apocarpus means if the carpels are free in nature, such a carpels we can call as apocarpus. If the carpels are free in nature, such a carpels we can call as apocarpus. Is it clear? So these are the four types of carpels. Next we can learn the structure of an anatropous ovule. What is an anatropous ovule? The ovule turns at 180 degree angle. Thus, it is inverted ovule. Micropyle lies close to hyla. Such a ovule we can called as anatropous ovule. Once again, the ovule turns at 180 degree angle. Thus, it is inverted ovule. Micropyle lies close to hilum. This type of ovule we can called as anatropous ovule. An anatropous ovule consists of the following parts. What are they? First one is funiculus, second hilum, third secondary nucleus, antipodal cell, raphe, chalaza, nucellus, integuments, embryo sac, egg cell, synergid, micropyle. All these are the parts of an anatropous ovule. Each parts we can learn clearly. First part is funicles. We can learn the first part. What it is? Funiculus or funicle. It is a stalk-like structure connecting an ovule or seed with the placenta. What is funicle? It is a stalk-like structure which connects ovule with the placenta. So that connecting structure we can call as funiculus. Is it clear? Next, hilum. What is hilum? The point of attachment of the body to funicle is known as hilum. The point of attachment of the body to the funicle we can call as hilum. So this region we can call as hilum region. Okay. Actually, it is the region of attaching the body to funicle. Okay. Next point. Integuments. Next structure is integuments. Okay. A protective structure. Actually, these are integuments. It is a protective structure that develops from the basal portion of an ovule and encloses it almost entirely except this micropylar region. What is an integument? It is a protective structure that develops from the base of an ovule and encloses it almost entirely except for a opening, that is micropyle at the tip of the nucellus. Okay, so this is the tip part of the nucellus. This is the nucellus and this part we can call as the tip part. In this tip part only what is located? Micropyle is located. Except this micropyle, all other regions are covered by integuments. Okay. What it is a protective structure. Is it clear? Next part we can learn as chalaza. What is chalaza? The basal part of nucellus. So this is the nucellus and basal part of the nucellus is swollen in nature. That swollen part we can call as chalaza. Okay, from this swollen region only what are arising? Integuments are arising. Okay, so once again, what is a chalaza? It is the basal part of the nucellus from where integuments are arising, and this region we can call as chalaza. Next, micropyle. A small opening found at the tip of integuments we can call as micropyle. So these are the integuments. At the tip of the integuments, what is present? A small opening present. That opening we can call as micropyle. Okay. Next, we can learn about nucellus. What is nucellus? The main body of an ovule is oval in shape, being composed of parenchymatous cells. What is nucellus? The main body of the ovule and oval in shape, and it is composed of parenchymatous cells. That oval body we can call as nucellus, and it is nutritive in function, because what is present in the nucellus? Reserved foods are stored. Okay. Next, we can learn about antipodal cells. The cells are present at the chalazal end. We can call as antipodal cell. The cells which are present at the chalazal end, we can call as antipodal cells. Okay. And they are nutritive in function. What is the role of these antipodal cells? They are nutritive in nature or in function. It nourishes the embryo sac. So that is the role of antipodal cells. Next, we can learn about synergid. Synergid. What is a synergid? Listen, it is the part of the egg apparatus. It is the part of the egg apparatus and are thought to help the pollen nucleus reach the egg nucleus, and it helps for fertilization. Okay. Actually, synergid, it is the part of that egg apparatus and are thought to help the pollen nucleus reach the egg cell for fertilization. That is the role of synergid. Okay. It helps in the fertilization process. Next one is Raphe. It is the portion of the funiculus that is united to the ovule wall. What is Raphe? It is the portion of the funiculus that is united to the ovule wall. So that portion we can call as Raphe. Next, we can learn about embryo sac. Okay. It is an oval shaped body where egg cells are present. Okay. Actually, embryo sac is the oval shaped body where egg cells are present. That oval shaped body we can call as embryo sac. Inside the embryo sac, egg cells are present. I think all parts are over. Already we explained about all parts. Next, we can learn some function of funicles, nucellus, micropyle, integuments and embryo sac. First, we can learn the function of funicle. It helps in the attachment of ovule with the placenta. Next, nucellus. It forms the nourishment tissue for developing embryo. Next, micropyle. Pollen tube enters the embryo sac through micropyle aperture. Next, integuments. They protect the inner tissue of ovule. Next, embryo sac. It contains embryo and endosperm nucleus. They later develop into endosperm to provide nourishment to the embryo. So these are the functions of the following parts. I hope all of you understood these points. If you have any doubt, you can put your comments in comment box. I will come with a new video in the next class. Till then, bye. Thank you.